I'm Jonathan Wall. I'm a deputy controller and commissioning editor of Radio 5 Live. I'm part of the 5 Live management team, which runs the strategy, commissioning, scheduling of 5 Live. I also commission all of our programming that we have from independent producers, which is about 15% of our output. I used to commentate on my Subbuteo games when I was 13, okay? And my parents said, you're quite into that, aren't you? And so I entered a national competition that was run by Radio 2, as it then was, which is where the sport used to be. And I came second in the country in this competition at commentating. So that was when I kind of knew I had a bit of a gift for broadcasting and radio. And that and my dad always used to listen to sport on the radio, so I was kind of brought into that world, really. And that's kind of what I wanted to do. And then I did hospital radio, and then I got a media degree, and then I did a postgraduate in broadcast journalism. Started out as a sports presenter and a reporter at local radio, Radio Humberside. And I then got a job as a researcher stroke assistant journalist in TV sport. So I used to write, the best bit of that was writing scripts for Des Lynam on Match of the Day. But that was a really good experience. And I did that for 2 years. And then I got a job as a producer in Radio Sport working on 5 Live. And I kind of just worked my way up to eventually be editor of all of the sports programmes and then to get the kind of deputy job at 5 Live. I would say that my most memorable moment in my career, it's a hard one, but I'd probably say Sydney 2000 Olympics, because it was the biggest event of its type. I went there as a kind of junior producer, but it was a real turning point in my career in that I felt that I rose to that event and was seen by kind of my bosses as being able to rise to that event. I kind of threw myself into it with every bit of passion. I probably did more preparation than anyone else for that event, was across every possible medal hope for Britain and where the stories would be, and kind of felt that hard work kind of paid off by, you know, I felt like I threw myself into it both sort of socially on the trip and professionally in terms of what I was able to deliver. And that was my springboard, really. I was already doing quite well, but that really moved me on to the next level and gave me loads more opportunities after that event. I think the best advice is you need to demonstrate a passion for radio, specifically, if that's where you want to work. I think that I always look at CVs and see where the sort of work ethic is and see how much people have really wanted it. So is there some student radio or hospital radio on that CV? In an interview or when you meet managers, have you been able to converse in a way that shows that you listen to speech radio as well as commercial radio and that you've got a real sense of what the industry's about? I think if you throw yourself into it like that, you can have a head start, really. But I think there's nothing better that at whatever level, whether it's community radio, student radio, hospital radio, than actually doing stuff, whether it's researching live programmes, presenting, producing, whatever it is. You know, I would say researching live radio, community radio, is better than making a tea at 5 Live, for example. It's actually being out there and doing stuff is what gets the experience going. It's what gets the confidence, and it's what tells me whether people really want to work in the industry or not. And it's so competitive that people have to work hard at finding those advantages for themselves and really showing that they really want it.